Hey everyone, welcome back to Vintage. As I mentioned last week, I'm not actually here. I'm away on holiday, but I've got so many good books that I want to talk about. I've pre-recorded this so that I can share more bookish joy with you. Last week I was talking about John Burnside's Ashland and Vine. If you haven't seen that video, you'll see a link appear here. This week I'm talking about Emily Ruskovich's debut novel, Idaho. So that's two American books in a week, in the same week. Anyway, there's nothing wrong with being in America. I wanted to talk about this book because, well, two main reasons. One, Emily Ruskovich is an insanely talented writer. This is her debut book, but the quality of the writing is just fantastic. It's beautiful, evocative, confusing. There's a sort of hazy atmosphere that covers the book, so you're never quite sure what's going on. And this leads me to my second point, which is that as soon as I finished this book, I felt I had a need to sort of talk to somebody else who'd read it about it, because I was confused about something. And I wanted to see what they thought. So I found somebody who'd read it, and they had a totally different conclusion for what had actually happened in the book, which seems to be an incredibly clever thing to be able to do as a writer, to have two people read the same book and to have reached an entirely different conclusion about what's actually happened in the book. And that is because this book is sort of infused with this theme of dementia. So we have a family, and the father of the family has sort of early onset dementia, and there's sort of an event that happens in the book and you're never quite sure what has happened. So Wade is the father and Jenny is the wife, and they go there with their two daughters to the woods to collect firewood, and whilst they are there, one of the daughters is killed with an axe, one of the axes they're using to chop wood, ostensibly by the mother, who then goes to prison for murder. And when we sort of pick up the story, we're picking it up from various sources throughout the book, and Wade has remarried and is with this other woman, and we're hearing about her life and about his life and about the life of Jenny in jail. It's a very confusing kaleidoscope of sort of voices and bits of the story. And the central question, of course, is what actually happened on that day. And that's what you're trying to solve as you go through, but not in a sort of crime novel kind of way, in a very much in a literary way. This is about memory. It is about how we lie to ourselves about what has happened. And there's this constant battle to work out what is true. Now, I'm quite a gullible reader, so I will basically believe what you tell me in a book. This is why I'm not very good at reading crime stuff and sort of trying to solve a mystery as I go through, because I'll just believe what you tell me. And then at the end, I'll be like, oh, what? I never guessed that. And so with this book, I think I probably followed what I had been told from the very beginning as far as what had happened, whereas the other person that I spoke to about it had come to a completely different conclusion because they probably used their brain a bit more than I had. But I just think that's really interesting to finish a book and to still not really have a clear idea about what actually has happened. And so it's not really about sorting out that problem. That is not the purpose of the book, to work out who killed the daughter or what actually happened on that day. But it is about the impact of that event on these people's lives. It is about loss. It is about memory. It is about love. It's about these very important themes. And I guess that when we talk about literary fiction, I guess that's what we mean, isn't it? That it's not about the plot. It's about the themes that it develops. And in this case, particularly with Emily Ruskovich, it's about enjoying some fantastic writing. Very excited to see what she does next. I think it's a fantastic debut, and so I think it'd be great to see where she goes next. Also, can we just have a little moment to describe how beautiful this cover is? Absolutely fantastic cover design. I believe done by the same person who created the cover for H's for Hawk. Book fact. So there you go. So that's Idaho by Emily Ruskovich. I have two copies as ever to give away. If you are interested, make sure you're subscribed. Leave a comment below, and I will be back to pick winners for both this and for the John Burnside next week, where I'll be talking about another book, which will probably be as brilliant as these, because I just like to talk to you about the good stuff. That's what I'm here for. Anyway, thank you for joining me this week, and I will see you next week. Take care.